And I'm hungry.
Nothing like being with family.
I am hungry. Come on now.
So, Carla, where you from?
Chicago.
Oh, Chicago. We have family there.
Chicago, the windy city, huh? I was working on a skyscraper in Chicago once, and my lunch blew up the 27th floor.
I figure your old fat ass a member of somebody's sandwich flying off a building.
Oh, baby, eat some bread.
So, Miss Purdy, are you and Sherman having relations?
That's a good question. No, Grandma, it's not like that. We're colleagues. Oh. We just work together.
Colleagues. Oh, yeah, that's how I start out, colleagues. Me and your grandfather was colleagues. Next thing you know, he's on top of me in the shed, pumping and sweating.
Yeah, Mode's not like that. Sherman, will you hush up? You never brought a girl home. The least you can do is let us talk to her.
Yeah, I'd like to get to know her a little better myself.
Ain't nothing wrong with having relations. Don't be ashamed of that. Relations is beautiful. When I was young, I used to always have relations. Every night, if a nice gentleman bring me flowers and candy, take me to a movie, show me a lovely evening, then I would take him home and give him hot, lovely relations. Relations is a beautiful thing. It's nothing to be ashamed of, especially to young people. I think that's your way, Edmund. You know, sometimes when I'm alone, I relate to myself.
I can relate.
Mama.
I don't want to hear this shit while I'm eating.
Please, stop talking to me.
So, Carla, do you like children?
Yes.
Oh, that's wonderful. I can't wait for Sherman to bring me home some grandbabies.
Yeah, I know you're going to enjoy making them babies. Got them child-bearing hips. Baby popped right out.
Your family got any money? I ain't paying for no big-ass wedding.
Oh, Carla, I know a wonderful minister. What religious background are you?
Yeah, you know, I still got my wedding dress. If you want it, I'll take it in and let you wear. You look so lovely, Aaron. It's white, though. Can you wear a white wedding dress, young lady? Now, Sherman, you can wear a white tuxedo. Did you know Sherman? Sherman's never had relations.
Mama, you gonna embarrass my baby.
Oh, don't pick out a strong back.
Oh, look at my
when
baby.
You get
look,
all you know, that man and release all that that's been built up for 35 years, just wanting and wanting and wanting, whoo, might make your head blow off.
Pop, go to Weezer.
I got my own self hot telling that story.
Pop, go to Weezer, Carla. Weezer say, pop.
Yeah, Carla, you and Sherman gonna get married here or in Chicago.
Carla, do you cook? Because somebody's got to feed my Sherman.
Yeah, I know a wonderful church down there on Main Street, but they won't marry you if you're a lesbian. Not that I have anything against lesbians. I love lesbians.
Lesbians is good.
Yeah, true. There's nothing wrong with a little bingo, a little cunnilingus. They ain't never hurt nobody.
Well, why is it the woman always get the choice where it's gonna be married?
Well, that's tradition.
Well, tradition my ass. Look, I ain't gonna pay for everybody to fly to no Chicago. You know how much plane tickets cost?
Aye, old cheap bastard.
If we go to Chicago, then we're gonna have to drive down there.
I'm not down to Chicago.
You ain't gonna drive to Chicago. Yeah, but then you're gonna be walking around the bike, because I ain't gonna have only. The wedding gonna be here.
My baby's not getting married. My baby is not getting married.
Oh, yeah. There you go again, popping off gas in front of this lovely young lady.
We trying to have a meal. You want to sit there and break on this gas.
I hope your ass turn into a frog.
I'm holding gas up in my ass.
Don't nobody want to hear your flatulence, please, clump. You such a disgrace.
I stopped holding my gas a long time ago. You know that.
Please, you going to spoil the dinner to everybody.
Say one more word. Say one
look
more word.
Look at how y'all have influenced this baby.
Listen, Carla. I want to apologize about my family back there. I think they got the wrong idea about things.
Oh, no, no. I should be the one to apologize. I'm so sorry if I seem distant tonight, but I still have Buddy on my mind.
You really care for Buddy, huh?
I don't know. I mean, on the outside, he seems so cocky and brash, but when I look in his eyes, I see kindness, I see warmth, and that's the side of Buddy I wanted to get to know. I just got way ahead of myself. Here I am talking your ear off once again about Buddy.
No, it's quite all right, really. Listen, Carla, don't you worry about Buddy. I'll find him for you.
Thank you, Sherman. Thank you for being such a good friend to me.
Good friend.